What?
This is as far as I go.
Do you need me to take some files?
Yes, thank you.
Come along, we have work to do.
This is as far as I go. My mother and daughter will be here soon.
But we have work to do. Mary, Monday's going to be here before we know it.
Bill, it's Christmas Eve. No more work. Not tonight, but all night.
I need your help. I just can't do this work alone. What's the matter, Mary? Are we not paying you enough as a consultant or what? Look, my apartment's right around the corner and I need your help. Come on.
Bill, I can't work tonight. My daughter's in the Christmas play. She's an angel, you know.
1 minute, Mary. One. Just 1 minute is all I need. I promise you. I cross my heart, but I can't.
That's what you said Thanksgiving. And as a matter of fact, you don't pay me enough. Not for hours like this.
Not hours, just 1 minute. One. Oh, please. Please. Please, please.
Okay,
please, please.
1 minute.
Yes. Ugh,
you are such a workaholic. Bill, just stop a minute, will you? Look around. Look at the people getting ready for Christmas. Look at their faces. Everyone is so happy. Just look, will you?
But Mary...
Just stop a minute, Bill. The accounts won't fall apart if you pause for a minute to look. It's wonderful. It's my favorite time of year. Will you look?
Oh, all right. There. Satisfied? Oh, come on, let's go.
Bill. Hi, Sugar Plums. You've been shopping?
Yeah, but you can't look. We got you a surprise robe.
Hush, big mouth. She's been pulling me all over town.
Mom, this is Bill from the agency.
Oh, yes. I've heard a lot about you.
Oh, well, none of it's true.
My thoughts exactly.
And you know Jenny.
Oh, yeah, I recognize her from the picture you showed me. But she's cuter in person.
Mom, would you mind taking Jenny home? I have a couple of quick things to do.
But you're singing tonight, and the pageant.
I gotta be an angel.
You're already an angel. Now, we'll have plenty of time. I'll only be 1 minute.
If you must, but hurry along. Come on, sweetheart.
I think they like me.
I'm sure they do.
Well, hurry along. We gotta make the most of that minute.
Carolers collecting money for orphans. Maybe they'll sing.
Maybe they will, and my apartment's just around the corner. I bet we can hear them from there.
Maybe they'll sing if I put money in the pot.
And maybe they'll come up to my apartment if I give them a credit card. Mary, please.
Now, here we go. I only want to hear a little bit.
Oh, all right. This is your minute, not mine. These graphs don't make sense. They're not right.
Bill, your minute has become 20.
But this is the last one. Please.
Oh, all right. Let me see.
Look at this chart. It just doesn't make sense.
Oh, I'm beginning to go cross-eyed. Everything's running together. Oh, I really have got to go.
Oh, come on. Just one more.
One more, right. I've got to pick up Jennifer from my mother's house and get her ready for the church service tonight. I'm seeing tonight, you know.
Did we ever get the proofs back on the Davis campaign, that magazine now?
I don't know that they'd be... Bill, I have got to go. I can't be late. This means a lot to Jenny.
But I've got to get these done. You know what they say, time waits for... Demanding clients don't wait, you know. Does Bob come over at Christmas?
No. We haven't seen him since the divorce was finalized. Oh, he sent a gift, and he'll probably make a phone call.
Sporting of him. I know those proofs were here.
I hate to leave you like this.
Well, then stay.
I don't hate it that much. Would you like to come to the service with me? And Jenny?
I'd better plow on.
Bill, it's Christmas Eve.
Huh?
It's Christmas Eve.
Yes, it is.
But your apartment, there's nothing here.
I didn't have time to do anything with it, but I have a Bing Crosby tape. He sings White Christmas.
That's all?
No, he sings a lot of Christmas songs.
No, I mean, that's all you have to celebrate Christmas?
Well, you know how busy we've been at the office. I know those proofs were here.
But
I saw them
earlier.
This
can't be all. You go to your parents' house, right?
No. I'm the last of a dying breed. My dad left when I was a kid. On Christmas Day, in fact, and my family scattered to the four winds. Look up dysfunctional in the dictionary, there's my family portrait. So it's just me and Bing. And Nat King Cole, if I can find the tape.
But that's no way to spend Christmas alone.
Oh, no, it's ideal. It's the only time I can get anything done. Nobody calls, nobody comes by, it's paradise.
But what about the Christmas spirit? You know, the celebration of the birth of Christ.
I'll watch Mr. Magoo's Christmas Carol on TV, that'll be fine.
Bill, it's all wrong. Christmas is a time to be with people, to share love and faith. Would you like to come to my apartment for Christmas dinner? It's just my family and we'd love to have you.
Have me for dinner? Wouldn't a turkey be better?
No, look, it'll be a quick dinner. Nothing fancy, quick,
no,
and you're gone.
Really, I'm fine, honest.
But Bill, you don't have any gifts, nothing to open. You don't even have a tree.
I joined an environmentalist group, and we're trying to stamp out the wholesale slaughter of innocent Christmas trees. It's a nonprofit club. We go to rallies, sign petitions, and really, it's better this way.
Could you be so insensitive? It's almost Christmas Day. No time for love. No time for feelings. Your heart's grown cold. It's like you time for
going to help anymore. You might as well get going.
But don't worry about me. Go home, drink some eggnog with Jenny, open presents, and forget about me because I'm fine.
But this isn't fine.
End of discussion. Now hurry along or Santa won't bring you any presents.
Oh, sometimes you drive me crazy.
And that's the essence of our relationship.
Call me if you change your mind about dinner. It's an open invitation.
I will. Thanks. Good night.
Good night. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
No time for love. No time for Christmas. It's a busy Christmas Eve, and I hardly can believe how the time does fly. All the work stacked high, now she says she has to leave. It's a busy Christmas Eve, there's so much to achieve, and I should have known I'd be on my own. It's a very busy Christmas Eve, my boss's face is gazing at the ticking clock. In this rat race, there's no time for a mental block. Pressure's building, gotta meet the day's deadlines. I am late and running out of time. It's a busy Christmas Eve, and I hardly can believe how the time does fly. All the work stacked high, how much worse could this day be? It's a busy Christmas Eve, there is so much to achieve. Oh, I should have known I'd be on my own. It's a very busy Christmas Eve, and I should have known I'd be on my own.
Mary, maybe I could wrap it and give it to her tomorrow.
Oh, I should have known I'd be on my own. It's a very busy Christmas Eve.
Bet you're the cause of all this. William. William, it's time to wake up.
Oh, okay, Dad. Be ready for school in a minute.
William.
Oh, 30 more seconds. Just give me 30 seconds.
Oh, man.
Hello.
Who are you?
What's the idea of screaming like that? You almost scared me to death.
Didn't do a whole lot for me either. What are you doing here? What do you want?
I'm just visiting. Will you stand still, please? You're making me dizzy.
Don't mess with me, buddy. I know karate.
Ha! You only had two lessons, and one was with your mom.
How did you know that?
Oh, I know a lot of things. You cheated on your taxes. You owe the IRS.
Shh. Anything else?
Two sugars in your coffee. You're coloring your hair. You act so very macho. But sleep with a teddy bear.
Don't you mock my Mr. Bear. Well, let me ask you. How many years till?
Seven.
So what's my favorite?
Red.
You don't know I like
jazz?
It's like he knows what's in my head.
I also know that apart from a puppy named Rascal, You have never loved, nor been in love. At least not with anyone other than yourself. Symptomatic of a closed heart, I think.
Oh, wait just a minute there. You...
Bill, I'm here to teach you.
Teach me? About what, breaking and entering?
I'm not a burglar. I'm a teacher. You have a great lesson to learn tonight, a lesson about Christmas. You're going to take a journey and meet some of my friends.
Oh, wait, I get it. The guys at the office put you up to this, right? What a bunch of pranksters.
This isn't a prank, Bill. You've been growing colder and colder towards Christmas, ignoring it, denying the spirit that desires to grow within you. We fear for your heart.
And who are you? The ghost of Christmas past? Well, you've got the wrong apartment. Scrooge is in 3A.
You're not taking this very seriously, Bill.
In a word, no. You're either a nut, a burglar, a prank, or I'm dreaming.
I told you I'm not a nut, a burglar, and this isn't a prank.
Then I'm dreaming. Of course. All the stress at the office is giving me bad dreams.
What are you doing? What is this? This isn't New Year's Eve.
This will make the journey a little easier.
Journey? We're going somewhere?
Of course. We're certainly not going to stay here.
Well, what do you want? What are you trying to prove?
I'm not trying to prove anything. I'm going to teach you about Christmas, the spirit, and the celebration.
Look, what did you say your name was?
I didn't say, but you can call me Bartholomew.
Okay, listen, Bart. You don't have to mess with all this. I love Christmas. It's a wonderful time of year.
But you don't celebrate it.
Don't celebrate it? What are you talking about, don't celebrate it? I've got eggnog in the fridge. Well, okay, so maybe I'm not into all that blatant commercialism of Christmas. I mean, all that Christmas ornamental, traditional... Just because I don't show all the trappings of Christmas paraphernalia does not mean I'm not celebrating it here, in my heart. And it's the heart that counts, right?
Exactly. And it's your heart we're going to deal with by showing you the hearts of others who have celebrated Christmas in years past.
Wrong. I've got work to do. So why don't you just hop on your broom or however it is that you travel and go haunt somebody else? I've heard about things like this. All I have to do is wake myself up. Here's what I'll do. I'll close my eyes, count to three. When I open my eyes, this whole silly dream will be over. And if you're not a dream, you better be gone or I'll call the police.
Okay, if you want to do this the hard way.
One, two, three. See? I'm awake. I knew it was only a dream. A lesson about Christmas. Bartholomew, how stupid! It's awfully dark in here. Hope we didn't have another power outage. Not the sounds of a normal apartment. I'm gonna have to talk to the landlord about this. I know there's a no animals clause in my lease.
Caleb! Caleb! Come quickly! Look! Let's look!
Guys, what's going on here? Stand up! Stand up and talk to me! Quit groveling! What are you, some kind of street gang? Well, forget about it, guys. I have nothing worth stealing. A Bing Crosby tape, if you have to know the truth, but... Guys! Guys, what's going on here? Guys! Guys!
To you is born this day. find this child in a manger bed. For this night in Bethlehem, our Savior is born. Our
Not so fast there.
Pretty impressive, huh?
Oh, yeah. It's overwhelming, especially the sheep.
You just witnessed the announcement of the birth of the Christ child. You, my foolish friend, got to see the very first Christmas celebration. And all you can think about is sheep? Huh, that's all you received from the whole experience?
What did you expect me to get out of it? It's a dream. I probably won't even remember this when I wake up.
Oh, you'll remember. Or forget to your own demise. You're being shown these things to give you an understanding of the Christmas spirit. Those shepherds felt it first, deep within their hearts in response to the birth of the Son of God. It was there that the Christmas spirit planted its first seeds for the celebration to blossom. But Christmas, as you know it, would need years to be nurtured and grow. It went through many changes, suffering at the hands of pagans and churchmen alike. Both would make it a holy day and a holiday. Yet, at the heart of it, always at the heart, the Spirit remained constant to the true believer, and not only on the 25th of December, but through all the year.
Yeah, right. I know all these things. I've read A Christmas Carol. You don't have to bother with all
but
this.
But I do. Your attitude compels me to. Come, there's more to learn. What a feast! Stavike, jelly, roast porpoise, boar, smelt, crayfish. Oh, and what's this? Bowl of wassail! What's wrong, Bill? Never seen a Christmas like this before?
Of course I have. It's just how we did it when I was a kid.
Then you must have been born a long, long time ago. Your modern age knows nothing of celebrating Christmas like this.
I'm not impressed. They don't have a tree either.
Christmas trees, as you know them, haven't caught on yet.
That's no excuse.
What did you expect? One of your plastic trees with electric lights, aluminium icicles, and a revolving star at the top? Department stores haven't been invented yet.
Christmas without department stores? It's blasphemous.
Just watch. With the activities surrounding Christmas here, they wouldn't have had time for such nonsense. The Lord of the House returns from the hunt.
A hunt? This isn't Easter.
Many of the nobles would go boar hunting on Christmas morn after the Christmas worship. Now cut the wisecracks and watch.
Won't they be upset that we were wandering around their place while they were gone?
They can't see us. We're strictly observers.
Yeah. blessed shepherds, and do not be dismayed.
Tournaments, jousting, spear throwing, races, a public test of valor and honor on the part of the knights. It too was part of the grandeur of Christmas. Never again will the world celebrate Christmas as they did it this time. Such zest, such spirit!
Well, let's go and see.
No, our time here is finished.
I want to see the tournament.
There's too much left for us to do. Come.
Spoil sport.
Oh, so now we want to get involved, do we? What about the pile of accounts on the table? I thought it was so urgent that you get back to them.
It is.
Oh, all right. Let's go. Wake me out of this.
I don't live in the Middle Ages. Fact is, I wouldn't want to. They may know how to throw a big bash at Christmas time, but it wasn't anything special the rest of the year.
Nor would I say that it was. Every age has its problems, its tragedies. But Christmas should take us out to their reach. For just one day out of the year, can't we glance beyond our temporal mortal lives and look to the one who died that we might have eternal life? That's something you've forgotten, Bill.
What now? Why is it so dark?
Because Christmas went dark.
Huh?
As time went on, the festivities got out of hand. Many forgot what they were celebrating. Remembrance of the birth of Christ was swallowed up by excessiveness. People used Christmas as an excuse for the wrong things. There were indulgences of all kinds, even riots.
Sounds like one of our office parties.
It became a mockery of what it was supposed to be. Church leaders grew intolerant of it, and in the enthusiasm of their good intentions, they almost destroyed the season altogether.
Isn't so bad.
Hush and watch.
But you said the season was almost destroyed. These people are very caught up in...
Watch.
But thou, Bethlehem Ephrathah, though thou be little amongst the thousands of Judah, yet out of thee shall he come forth to be ruler in Israel, whose going forths have been of old and everlasting. Therefore will he give them up until the time that she which travaileth hath brought forth. Then the remnant of his brethren shall return unto the children of Israel. And he shall stand and feed in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God, and they shall abide. For now shall they be great unto the ends of the earth. And this man shall be the peace.
The 25th of December, a day that is not even a Sabbath, do you hold services?
Is it against the law to hold prayer services?
Prayer services? Who is it you pray for on this odd day? Do you pray for Charles Stewart?
Not only Charles Stewart, but for all Christian kings, princes, and governors.
Then in doing so, you pray for the King of Spain as well, who is our enemy. You pray treason!
Hush, daughter.
Then speak the truth. This is not merely a prayer service, but a service for Christmas and a sacrilege as well.
This is not a sacrilege. We are giving thanks for the birth of his son.
Why, contrary to the ordinance made, do you observe such a superstitious time as the Nativity? It is a pagan holiday and outlawed.
It is the birth of our Savior and to be honored.
You will cease this ignorant ceremony and go your separate ways.
We will not.
Then we defy you.
I will read scripture. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word is with God.
You forced me to
the
take
same
action.
As in the beginning with God.
We cannot tolerate this sacrilege.
All things are made that were not made without
Cease.
Him. In
I
him is the life, and the life
all.
Is the light of men. And the light shineth Lord. In the darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not.
Mary. No!
Who said that? Who called out?
I did. You can't do this. It's wrong.
Hey,
who said that? Whose fault? Tell me!
I don't know. It came from back there. It came from nowhere.
They heard me shout. I thought you said they couldn't hear us.
I don't know. That's never happened before.
Take him to the prison. We will discuss this matter and turn him over to the magistrate. It is the work of demons.
Demons? Ha! He's got a lot of nerve.
What will happen to Mary, to them?
Fortunately, they'll only be fined this time.
I don't understand. They weren't riding or indulging themselves or anything. It was just a little service.
And the innocent suffer with the guilty. Christmas was outlawed for all. It was to become a season like any other season, a day like any other day. You would have liked that, I suppose. Just think of all the work you could have done.
Well, what happened next? Christmas didn't stay outlawed.
As is true of so many edicts and ordinances of men, the Christmas spirit lived on in spite of them. Powers changed, the government came and went, and the desire for Christmas returned. The Christmas tree, as you know it, began to catch on and was set in the middle of a table, covered with garland and greenery, small homemade toys and ornaments, sometimes fruit, gingerbread, and always with candles. There was everything and more. Everyone left themselves to complete abandonment to mirth and good fellowship, bringing together both peasant and lord and blending all ranks in one warm, generous flow of joy and kindness. Imagine the crackling fire, the carols sung, the holly, the mistletoe, oh, the goose and the Christmas pudding.
Yeah, you make it sound great, but where is it? This looks like something out of Dickens.
Well, you're close.
Oh, will Scrooge be showing up soon?
Scrooge was fictional. This is not. Yet, ironically, it was good that Scrooge did show up. His fictional conversion helped rekindle the Christmas spirit in his time. In an age of industrial revolution and technological change, Scrooge helped remind his people that Christmas needed to be celebrated, and it takes a changed heart to do it properly. Dickens made that very clear in his Christmas Carol. And a changed heart can overcome anything, even poverty.
Morning, children. And a very Merry Christmas to you all. It is Christmas, you know. Why so many gloomy faces? We should be making merry.
Yes, Mom. We know it's Christmas, Mom.
But what, Jane? Speak up, my girl.
What she means is, Mom, what do we have to make it merry?
Oh, now that's a good question, Gwendolyn. But say, I'll tell you what we don't have to make us merry. To celebrate the occasion, I have decided to suspend all work for the day.
Yay!
Oh. No chores?
No chores, Jonathan.
No schoolwork, Mum?
That's right, Edgar.
Even arithmetic, Mum.
Even arithmetic, Sarah.
Oh, thank you, Mum. Arithmetic gives me an A.
We will make it a day to celebrate. First, we will have breakfast. And then, a small worship service to wish our Lord a most happy birthday. And then, sledding!
Yay! How can we do this after breakfast, Mommy?
We have no food for
breakfast. Oh, you're such a sour person.
Now, children. We must have faith. God has provided for us till now. He will continue to do so, I'm most sure. Now, Elizabeth, I will not have such talk. You could be in the mines or the factories. Faith must be strong, regardless of the situation. Come, children. Let's sing a song for Christmas morning. Perhaps, if we sing a song of praise loud and heartily, the Lord will be so impressed that he can't help but send us breakfast, knowing that we will eat to his glory and spend the day celebrating his generosity, eh? With a little bit of faith, we can do it. With a little bit of hope, come what may. And no matter what the test, we'll make it through it. It's not hard to see the answers on its way. With a little bit of faith,
we can do it.
Better with a little bit of faith. I think she's got it. And no matter what the test, we'll make it through it. It's not hard to see the answers on its way. Everybody!
With a little bit of faith, we can do it.
Come on,
we might as well be pregnant.
children, remember what you learned now. Come on, little bit of faith, we can do it. With a little bit of hope, come what may. And no matter what the test, we'll make it through it. It's not hard to see the answers on its way. Just in time! Wait your turn. Peggy Lewis, say thank you. Wait your turn. Wait your turn. Say thank you. Good. Oh, Bartholomew, my good friend, you are a messenger from God himself. It would have been a frightfully dismal Christmas if you hadn't come along.
Oh, we're glad to be of service.
You make the holiday so special for the children, and for me as well. They're often forgotten at times of year such as this. And thank you, Father Christmas.
Ho, ho, ho. No wrong character.
You've made the children very happy. They're often forgotten at times of year such as this. Will you stay for breakfast?
Sure. What you having?
A hot bowl of gruel.
Oh, better pass. Gotta stick to my diet, you know.
We must be running along. We have a great distance to go.
Well, you are more than welcome to stay.
Come quick! David hits Robert in the head with his toy soldier!
Oh my goodness, that just won't do for Christmas Day!
That was fun. Did you see the children's faces when we came through the door?
Yes, yes I did.
They really thought I was Father Christmas. You know, it gave me a good feeling doing that.
Something wrong, Bill?
I was just thinking about some carolers who were collecting money for orphans. I should have given them something.
Follow me. We have one more stop left. Except for a few modifications, the way people celebrate Christmas in the 20th century isn't much different from the Victorian Christmas. The tree, the mistletoe, presents, so much of it is unchanged.
Here we come a-caroling among the leaves so green, and here we come a-wandering so fair to the sea. Come and joy come to you, and a merry Christmas too, and God bless you and send you a happy new year. And I send you a happy new year.
We are the daily beggars, who beg from door to door.
chime, a chance sublime of peace on earth, goodwill to men.
The Virgin Mary had a baby boy.
The Virgin Mary had a baby boy. The Virgin Mary had a baby boy.
And they said that his name was Jesus.
He come from the glory.
He come from the glorious kingdom.
He come from the glory.
He come from the glorious kingdom. Oh, yes, believer.
Oh, true believer. He come from the glory.
Now you've seen Christmas at its best and at its worst. Did you learn anything?
Well, I learned that Christmas was outlawed for a while. I didn't know that.
What? That's all you've learned?
I was kidding. Boy, some people can't take a joke.
Then tell me what you've learned. From your heart, tell me what Christmas means to you.
Well, first there were the shepherds celebrating. And Richard and the Wassel.
I've done all I can.
What do you want from me, Bart? Do you want me to promise to put up a tree in my apartment from now on? You want me to exchange presents, kiss under the mistletoe? What promises do you want from me?
Those are mere appearances, Bill. I expect no promises from you. In fact, I don't expect anything from you. I believe you when you say that you'll wake up and forget all this. Wouldn't be practical or advantageous to your career to distract yourself remembering what you witnessed here tonight. No, sir, I've done all I can. In all the years of my existence, I have seen the Christmas spirit survive many things. It's overcome tragedy, poverty, persecution, even attempts to stop it. But the one thing it cannot overcome is a cold, indifferent heart. A heart that won't stay open to that child in the manger. That's what will kill Christmas. You think you are religious, and I believe you. More's the pity. There is nothing sadder than a heart that thinks it knows Christ, but will not respond to him. You don't realize how much you're missing. I'm done with you. Go back to work. But I warn you, young man, the great tragedy of today's Christmas is loneliness, a loneliness of the heart, of the soul. Many people will spend today alone and lonely, and it is not by choice. You choose it now. One day you will not, and then it will be too late.
My life. As long as it doesn't affect anyone else, it should matter only to me. I didn't ask you to do all this. I'm gonna go to my chair and wake myself up. Ooh, this isn't my apartment. Bart, you dropped me off in the wrong apartment. What are you trying to do, get me arrested? Bartholomew? Terrific. Mary, I have an explanation for this, I really do, but...
Mom, I can't believe she fell asleep at the service. Must be the excitement of being an angel.
Guess I'm still invisible. Bart, what's going on here?
Beautiful service. If I wasn't in the Christmas spirit before, I am now. I'll never forget the look of the sanctuary when we lit the candles and you sang Oh Holy Night.
I don't think it's ever looked more beautiful. Thanks for taking us. Would you like some tea or anything?
Oh, no, thank you. I better go. Your father's waiting in the car. We should come over in the morning?
Oh, yes. First thing. Jenny will want to open her gifts.
And dinner, you're still determined to eat here.
Yes, Mother, I can still cook a turkey, you know. Besides, I've invited a friend.
Bill?
Yes, Bill.
I don't understand you at all. He barely notices you're alive unless he needs some help with his accounts or some other such nonsense. Why do you waste your time? He's so engrossed in his work. He probably won't even remember your dinner invitation. Mary, I don't know him, but I know his type. His work is everything. His heart is made of ambition and nothing else.
I don't believe that, Mother.
Oh, Mary, I know how difficult it's been for you since Bob left. Funny how the Christmas could be the most difficult time. Funny how the most joyous time of the year can also be the most lonely. You do whatever you think's best, Mary.
I will, Mom. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, darling. Good night.
Did our talking wake you up, sweetie?
I thought Santa Claus was
Santa won't come until he's absolutely sure you're asleep. Now, why don't you go on to bed before you make him late?
Oh, okay. Is Daddy going to come home for Christmas, Mommy?
No, sweetie, he's out of town and he won't make it. But if you go to bed real soon, maybe Santa Claus will bring some gifts special from him.
But why can't Daddy bring them himself?
Because he's gone away for Christmas with his new wife and he won't make it back in time.
Oh, I guess he loves her more than us, huh?
Oh, no, sweetheart. He loves you very much. Now, please, no more questions, okay? Go to bed.
Okay, good night.
Good night, sweetie.
Bart, what are you trying to do?
Doesn't anybody assemble anything for you anymore? Part B, part A, and connect. Connect. No, I won't cry. Dear God, please don't let me cry. Father, give me strength. I want to keep my eyes focused on you. I refuse to spend another Christmas in self-pity. Shattered dreams, broken promises, and a life torn in two. Silent cries, painful memories, just trying to make it through. Is there something beneath this tree? Start looking for a miracle to heal a wounded heart, a gift of hope, a touch of Christmas is a time to look at Jesus Christ and what he's done for me, not to look at myself and my own petty problems. Look at me, now I'm talking to myself. Bill, this is all your fault. It was just a simple dinner invitation. Guess that's what I get for opening up my heart again.
I didn't know. I didn't know. Bart, I know you're around here somewhere. Make me visible, let me be heard, please. I want to do something. I want to help. Please, Bart. I didn't realize. I didn't realize.
Mary, I don't know him, but I know his type. His work is everything. His heart is made of ambition, nothing else.
This isn't a prank, Bill. You've been growing colder and colder toward Christmas, ignoring it, denying the spirit that desires to grow within you. We fear for your heart. You have never loved, nor been in love. Symptomatic of a closed heart, I think.
Let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us.
A child this day is born, a child of high renown, most worthy of a scepter and a crown. Come in, come in. The table is spread and the festivities are about to begin.
This is not a sacrilege. We are giving thanks for the birth of his son.
Our faith should be strong regardless of the situation. Perhaps if we sing a song of praise loud and heartily, the Lord will be so impressed that he can't help but send us breakfast, knowing that we will eat to his glory and spend the day celebrating his generosity, eh?
In all the years of my existence, I have seen the Christmas spirit survive many things. It has overcome tragedy, poverty, persecution, even attempts to stop it. But the one thing it cannot overcome is a cold, indifferent heart. A heart that won't stay open to that child in the manger. That's what will kill Christmas. You think you are religious, and I believe you. More's the pity. There's nothing sadder than a heart that thinks it knows Christ, but does not respond to him. You don't realize how much you're missing.
Bartholomew!
A dream. Mary, what?
Bill, I just can't stand the thought of, did I wake you up?
No, yes, but I had to answer the door anyway. Mary, what are you doing here?
I know this is forward of me, Bill, but I can't stand the thought of you spending Christmas this way. It's wrong. I know we talked about it last night, but I won't let you do it.
Okay.
You're spending the day with me and my family.
Okay.
Don't even try to argue because I... Okay?
Okay.
But
Mary,
not...
I want to tell you... Mary, sometimes I'm really blind. I get so caught up in things, my own life, my own goals, and I can't see beyond the end of my nose, but I got it all wrong. I thought I could ignore the spirit of Christmas, but in my heart, I can't do that anymore. I'm not making any sense, am I?
No.
Mary, I want you to know that I'd really like to have Christmas dinner with you today.
You would? But what about all the work?
Forget about it. It's Christmas. It'll wait. You know what your problem is? You don't know how to relax and enjoy the holiday. It's all work with you. Mary, I'd like to talk with you about your situation.
My situation?
I know how Jenny feels, you know.
You said your father left on Christmas Day.
Yeah, and maybe there's something I can do to help her to understand. Maybe you can help me too.
Help you?
I want to know more. I always thought I was a Christian because I used to go to Sunday school, but it never really made a difference. And what you have does. I want you to tell me more about the Christmas spirit.
I think you mean the spirit of Christ.
Maybe I do.
Just come to dinner and we'll talk. Listen, Bill.
You know, there's a soup kitchen at the end of the block. They make a feast of it every Christmas.
Let's go down and help, and then we'll go home.
Okay. Oh, and then maybe I can figure out how to put that silly dollhouse together.
I only finished half of it. Wait, how did you know about that dollhouse?
You must have told me. How else would I know? Oh, Merry Christmas.
In all of history, there's no better Christmas than the one you celebrate now. If you celebrate it with an open heart, Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
It has been our privilege to serve you and our Lord Jesus Christ this night with this musical. There are two or three other groups of people that we would like to recognize in a very special way, for without their help, none of this would be possible. First of all, the guys and gals in the balcony, our technical crew, would you give them a round of applause? Bless them with your hands. There you go, guys. Also, these beautiful costumes that you have seen tonight, are there any seamstresses here tonight? Did you sew any of the costumes that you saw on the stage tonight? Would you stand, please, where you are? I know of at least a couple. Lois Casey's back there, Tony Galloway, Debbie Orell. And finally, those who are stagehands, a sweaty crew indeed, working behind the scenes to make sure everything goes well. Stagehands, come on out. Again, we thank you for coming tonight, and we assure you that any good you see on this stage was not here until Jesus got here. May God richly bless your Christmas season with you and your family. May you have a wonderful holiday season. Go in the peace and love of the Lord. God bless you all. Good night.